For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future. You are now tuning into the program, Strong Nation, with your host, Pastor Marcos.
Very good afternoon to you and welcome to our program, Strong Nation. This Monday, I want to show you evidence of the power of God. Because maybe you are in a distressful situation, financially speaking, and you think that there is nothing, absolutely nothing, that will ever work out for you. Because you have been trying. You are a very hard worker. You have skills. You have experience. You have the know-how. But you do not see progress. Your life has been a life of struggles, a life of challenges, and you do not know what else to do. In these days of crisis, you have been thinking that there is absolutely nothing else you can do to bring you the result desired. But I'm here to show to you that there is a whole lot you can do that will bring you the result desired. And I'll show you testimonies. People who thought as you are thinking. People who have been through what you are going through. People who also were desperate, in need of help. People who knocked doors, but doors were never open. People who sought help, but help was not found. People who were in need of answers, but finally they received it. Let us see what these people did in order for them to be answered. And then, let us follow the example, because the same God who changed their lives will also change yours.
You are now watching Strong Nation.
Hello, Janelle.
How are you doing? I'm good, Pastor. Good evening.
Okay, that's good. Janelle, but not everything has been good for all those years, right?
No, Pastor.
How long are you coming to the church?
Pastor, it could be about 10 years now.
10 years
yeah,
now.
Yeah, from December 2009 to now.
Mm-hmm. And what about before those 10 years? Let us rewind the tape and let us cut 10 years of your life. Mm-hmm. How was it?
Pastor, really bad, you know, because I grew up in a broken home, as you would say. I didn't grow up with my both parents. So that in itself is be a big mental block for children growing up. Growing up, I grew up in a broken home, as you would say. I didn't have my parents in the same household as me. So that in itself was a disadvantage to me growing up because I grew up not having my dad around. And through not having my dad around, I always missed that attention of having a father figure in my life. You know, I had my mom, she tried her best, but there's only a certain amount of things that a mother on her own could do with a child.
And from what age have you realized that, you know, all those problems were teaming up, you know, in your family, in your house? At what age?
Pastor, from the age of 15. From the age of 15, I got wild. You know, I was already going to high school and I got myself involved with friendships who used to drink and smoke marijuana and stuff like that. You know, from the age of 15, I started sleeping around.
So from the age of 15, you start sleeping around, get involved with people that were smoking marijuana.
Yes, Pastor.
Have you got involved to marijuana also?
To smoke it. So the first time I smoked marijuana, it was a family member actually, because I had a side of family who believe in the Rastafarian faith. So smoking marijuana was normal to them. So every time I used to go on vacation by my dad, you know, I was exposed to that kind of lifestyle because that's the kind of lifestyle he had. He had a lot of women and he wasn't really a parent. You know, he used to leave me there in the house and go all over the place. So I was left there with families, with friends. It was like a big party every time he gone. You know, so I had permission to do whatever I wanted to do from a young age.
So from the age of 15, you already had permission to do whatever you wanted.
Yes.
And what was the worst moment of your life, Janelle?
For me, the worst moment, Pastor, was losing my ex-boyfriend. He got sick and he died. You know, because I always look for love in relationship, and I always look for that, wanting to have that sense of being in a relationship and having somebody there for me. And when I met him, you know, I thought, well, okay, this is it. We were living together. And I thought that, okay, this is it. This is the person I'm going to be with. I'm going to marry. I'm going to have a home, have a family. But he got sick and died, you know? So all my hopes and dreams for that ideal situation I was looking for all my life went down when he died.
And were you deep in a stage of depression, suicidal thoughts because he passed away? You had a lot of plans, a lot of dreams.
Yes, Pastor. I started going back because at the point in time when he got sick, I used to be, my mom introduced me to the church. And I used to come to the church and go to the hospital and visit him and stuff like that. You know, but, you know, when he died, is that everything that I learned in church went out the window. You understand? Because I really was there for him, for him to be saved.
So that was the bottom of the pit.
That was the bottom of the pit. And I was like, my God, why? Why would this happen?
Have you come to the point of blaming God because of his death?
I did, to the fact, but it had a moment, Pastor, because when I came in the church, I came in for him to be healed and to be okay. Mm-hmm. You understand? And my request to God in my time, and I didn't really think about it much, I never asked God for him to live forever. I asked God to give me the opportunity to save him. Don't make him die like this.
So my friend, perhaps the same thing that Janelle went through in life is the same thing that you are going through right now, because maybe her past is your present today. Because you have lost someone, you have lost the love of your life, because you have lost a job, now you are in a state of deep depression. And maybe you cannot find your way out of it. But yet, we can help you. Coming up, we are going to show to you the life story. Now, the other end, how her life is today. We are going to show to you, and you are going to see that also you can find a way out of this problem that you are going through, that you are facing.
You are now watching Strong Nation.
The great cry out for those who have debts and are unemployed. And every man who was in trouble was joined, and every man in debt, and every man of disgusted spirit. And he became their captain, and there were about 400 men with him. Join us in this great cry out on Monday the 27th at 5 p.m., also at 6 a.m., 10 a.m., 12 o'clock noon, at 3 p.m. and 6:30 p.m. at number 40 South Quay, Port of Spain, and all Universal Churches countrywide.
You are now watching Strong Nation.
So friends, we are back here with Janelle, and she's going to be telling us now how her life was totally transformed. So Janelle, you said that you were depressed, were feeling down, discouraged, because your ex, the coming law, yeah, the person that you used to live with had passed. So how were you after that, and how have you overcome that, the addiction, and also you had your life transformed?
But Pastor, I had to make a decision that he has died and my life had to go on. It was not easy, but I was already coming to the church before he died. So I know the church was there to help me. So I went back to the church and I started to do the chain of prayer to work on myself. I started with doing the chain of prayer for my deliverance. And little by little, things started to change within me. You know, I used to smoke a lot, I used to drink a lot. And my desires for doing these things, little by little, they faded away. Until I didn't even realize that I had no desire to smoke or drink. And then from there, it moved to me with regards to having that peace inside. Because even though I overcome the drinking and the smoking, I still had the turmoil inside of me. I still have the ache because I was young still. And I'm thinking, oh my gosh, I went through this great loss in my life. I used to prepare myself for loss, but I never thought it would have been that. So I had a lot of things inside of me that I needed to work on, Pastor. I needed to heal my heart. And I needed to work on my mind because my mind was all over the place, you know, because I couldn't really focus on day-to-day activities because of that. So coming to the church, I started to hear more about the Holy Spirit, you know, and I realized this would be the solution to my problems. And I started seeking to receive the Holy Spirit. And when the Holy Spirit came, that is when the peace came. That is when I learned to love myself and believe in me as a person. It didn't happen overnight, Pastor. It took me basically, could be about 4 years, working on myself.
So 4 years fighting to be free from all that?
Yes, Pastor. Because, you know, after a relationship, our natural desire is to want to jump back into the next relationship. But we have to heal first. We have to come to terms, especially when you go through a loss. You know, you have to heal totally from everything that could be hidden there. And I had a lot of things hidden inside that I didn't even know about. And those things is what the Holy Spirit revealed to me. And I was able to work on it. I was able to work on my mental stability, you know. And the Holy Spirit bring that sense of direction on how to pick back up the pieces, you know. I started to desire more in my career. Because before it was just, okay, I have a good job. And, you know, it had opportunities for promotion. But I never had those desires because, you know, the desires was before for the life outside. But when the Holy Spirit came upon my life, it brings about that desire to be more. You know, I remember the company member and I said, my God, I want you to take me to the top in here. I don't know how far you will take me. You understand? But this is my desire and I seek for that. And from that moment when I got that desire to be more, in a space of a year, I got 2 promotions. You understand? So after that 4 years, my life really begun after I received the Holy Spirit. That is when I saw a rapid progression in my life.
And how is your life today?
Pastor, my life today is good. You know, I have a stable job. You know, I have, you know, not only the financial benefit to do what I want to do, but the joy and the peace I have inside. No one could take it away from me.
And what about the liming, partying, smoking?
No desire for those things, Pastor. I don't miss it. You know, it's a different life now. You know, some people might say it's boring, but to me, I am having the best time of my life now, at the stage I am right now. And this is what the Holy Spirit brings to me.
Amen. Praise God. So, Janelle, what do you have to say to those who are going through presently, this person is going through the same thing you went through before?
Pastor, what I say to them is that not everything is lost. You have to make the decision on your own. Enough is enough. You have to reach that point in your life where you say, I cannot continue like this. And when you reach that point, God is there and He's willing to help you. You cannot do it on your own.
So friends, as she said, you cannot do it on your own. So let us help you today. Give us a call, 389-9880-709.
You are now watching Strong Nation.
As you saw the testimonies of these people, you can also see the same happening in your life. You can also experience the same transformation that they did. You can also benefit as they have benefited from God's promises. When you make a pact with the Word of God, what is written comes to pass. Because everything that is written in the Word of God is meant to become reality in the life of those who believe. So what to do? You have to make a pact with the Word of God. You have to follow the example of those who have had an experience with God, as these people who you just watched right now. So I would like to invite you who are watching us to take a piece of paper and to write down every problem you are facing in your financial life. Yes, write it down, the stress, the struggles, the challenges, the difficulties, and all the setbacks that you might have had. And you are going to carry it with you to the nearest, to the closest universal church to you. Even tomorrow, because probably you'll not be able to be with us today for 5 p.m. service, as the service is still on, or for 6:30 in the evening. But tomorrow, you are going to bring it to the closest universal church to you. You are going to hand it over to the pastor's hands, and he is going to make a strong prayer on your behalf and advise you about the steps you have to take for your life to change. Bear in mind that every Monday we have the Strong Nation Gathering of Faith countrywide at 5 p.m. in all the universal churches, especially in our national headquarters, number 40, South Key. You who want a breakthrough, you who want to see progress in your life, you who want to conquer, you who want to be the head, you who want to be at the top, you who want to be successful, financially independent, you are invited to join us. Doesn't matter your religion, doesn't matter your spiritual background, doesn't matter your past experiences, God is able to make you successful, as he did to these people whose testimony we are going to watch right now.
You are now watching Strong Nation.
My name is Christelle Joseph. Before coming to the Universal Church, my financial life was not where I wanted it to be. Sometimes all I had was money just to buy what I want, nothing extra. And that used to bother me. The hardest thing for me was that I had to travel. I wanted my own vehicle and I could not afford my own vehicle. I would always get, when I go to financial institutes, I would always get a no. And that used to bother me. Sometimes I would hire a taxi and the taxi used to charge so much. Sometimes when they come for you, they come late. Sometimes to drop my children to school, we'd reach late, to come to church, we'd reach late. And I got revolted. I got tired of that. I got fed up of that situation. I came to the Universal Church due to a problem of a family member. I didn't know about the Universal Church. I didn't even know that it existed. But someone invited me to the church and said that whatever problems that family member have, go with them and speak to the pastor. I did came to the church and we spoke to the pastor. And from that day, I continued coming to the church. I took part in the chain of prayer on Mondays. Mondays for my financial life and followed the teachings of the pastor. Due to following the teachings of the pastor and taking part in the chain of prayer, being persistent, going every Monday and following the directions of the pastor, my financial life changed. Today, my financial life is totally blessed. Now I can go to the supermarket and pick up anything that I want. And I don't have to worry about how am I going to pay for it. Today I have my brand new vehicle, my own vehicle. That no that I was getting all the time from financial institutes, that turned into a yes. I no longer have to hire a taxi to get embarrassed or like feel like I am begging. I have my own vehicle. Today my life, my financial life is totally blessed.
You are now watching Strong Nation.
The great cry out for those who have debts and are unemployed. And every man who was in trouble was joined, and every man in debt, and every man of disgusted spirits. And he became their captain, and there were about 400 men with him. Join us in this great cry out on Monday the 27th at 5 p.m., also at 6 a.m., 10 a.m., 12 o'clock noon, at 3 p.m., and 6:30 p.m. at number 40 South Quay, Port of Spain, and all Universal churches countrywide.
You are now watching Strong Nation.
I am Dale Joseph. Before attending to the Universal Church, my financial life was completely destroyed. I used to get paid. I was working and I used to get paid from Friday and Saturday, the next following day. I used to be completely broken. Had no money at all. At times, I used to borrow money from friends and even family members, and even waste money on unnecessary things. Heading to parties, clothing, expensive clothing, things that was not profitable to me. Just by seeing what people have and believe that I could have the same also. My worst encounter being in debt that was that I had a vehicle and at a point in time I was unable to pay for it until it reached the position that I was almost repossessed and I had no money at all. After being always in party, my mom invited me on numerous occasions to attend to the service. It had a point in time that I came home 6 o'clock in the morning and she woke me up and I had no other choice but to attend the 7 o'clock service. Coming to the church, my mom brought me, and from the beginning, I was not too sure that I was supposed to be here. But on just hearing the pastor speaking about faithfulness and certain circumstances that we may be going through, then I realized this service was for me. What he was preaching about touched me deeply because of the situation in my financial life I was going through. So after hearing the pastor speaking about being faithful, I decided to give it a shot. It's either all or nothing. I saw the blessings of God manifest into my life. My financial life started to grow. I got a better job with a greater salary, twice the amount I was getting before. But that was not all. I decided to go on Monday service for financial life, and where I took the same teaching of the pastors and decided to open my own business. Now, I'm working for a company that is paying 3 times the amount of salary I was getting from before I attended to the church. And now, I have my own business. What has been prosperous. So my life today, my financial life today is completely blessed. I have my own vehicle, I have my own business, and I'm working for a great salary one side with an outer company. I've been able to provide for myself and for my family.
You are now watching Strong Nation.
The great cry out for those who have debts and are unemployed. And every man who was in trouble was joined, and every man in debt, and every man of disgusted spirit. And he became their captain, and there were about 400 men with him. Join us in this great cry out on Monday the 27th, at 5 p.m., also at 6 a.m., 10 a.m., 12 o'clock noon, at 3 p.m., and 6:30 p.m. at number 40 South Quay, Port of Spain, and all Universal churches countrywide.
You are now watching Strong Nation.
I am Patricia Cadiz, and my financial life has been terrible. It has been dull. I became depressed when I think about my finances and the situation that I was in. There are times when, and this is my worst moment, when to pay the bills on a mountain, it was frustrating. I had to be juggling bills. Pay one, leave off the other. Try to catch up. Sometimes borrow into next month's salary to meet this month's expenses. So it was tough. At that point in time, I was a single parent. And it was really, really hard, depressing, and frustrating. I didn't know what else to do. When I came to the Universal Church, I was introduced to the chain of prayer Monday for finances, to fight for my financial breakthrough, and I did. And I remembered at one time being unemployed. I was unemployed for actually 2 years. And I didn't know what to do, where to turn. And I could say that the altar has answered my call, has answered my prayer. I did the chain of prayer. I did the purpose to fight for your justice as well. Because even long after, when I really received a good full-time permanent job, injustice was taking place in my life. And I fight and I cried out for justice. Today I can say I received my justice. I received the promotion that I really worked hard for to achieve. And my income today is almost double. My income now is in 3 different levels. And it's a joy. It's a pleasure because it came from God. I know it came from God. And more opportunities keep coming each and every day. And it can only happen through faithfulness and being faithful to God. Because when you return to God, He returns to you. And He returns to you much more than what you have returned to Him. So it pays to be faithful to God. Remember the altar, because the altar is where it gives you everything.
You are now watching Strong Nation.
We have great news. All the inspiring, uplifting, and positive content we at the Universal Living Faith Network bring you will now be available through various more television operators. You can now enjoy our special programming through DirecTV on channel 379, Charter Communications on channels 472 and 496, Verizon Fios on channel 795, Frontier on channels 226 and 726, as well as Consolidated Communications, Buckeye Broadband, and Hotwire Communications. Stay connected and let all your friends know.
You are now watching Strong Nation.
If you'd like to get hold of us, you can give us a call. You can text us 389-9880-709-8062. We also have our online pastor 24 hours a day, a new platform that you can get in touch with one of our pastors no matter the time. Whenever necessary, whenever needed, you can get hold of us. In order for you to gain access to the online pastor, follow the guidelines that will be played to you right now.
You are now watching Strong Nation.
Perhaps with all the situation the world is facing nowadays, you feel lonely, frustrated, and have no one to talk to. Perhaps you're under quarantine and isolated from loved ones, and going to church and speaking to a pastor face to face is no longer an option. Thinking about you, the Universal Church created the online pastor live chat. 24 hours a day, pastors are on standby to listen to you, give a word of faith, and pray for you and your family. Completely free and confidential. To access this service, visit ulfn.org/onlinepastor. When you click on the specific problem or the Speak to a Pastor button, a dialog box will pop up. Fill in your information. Agree to the terms and begin chatting immediately. You have 3 options: text, voice, and video. Need to speak to a pastor today? Just visit ulfn.org/onlinepastor. Available 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, free to all.
You are now watching Strong Nation.
So my friend, what are you waiting for? Time has come for your life to change. Time has come for you to experience the power of God. You saw all people testifying, saying, I came on Monday, I did my chain of prayer, I listened to the word of God, I obeyed the guidance I have received, I exercised my faith. And today, my life is no longer the way it used to be. The same is applicable to you. One guidance, one word can change your whole life. One word can take you from this distressful situation in and make you as successful as you never thought you would ever be. So make use of your faith. Time has come, now it is, for you to conquer, for you to be the head. So when we come back, it will be our moment of prayer. So get your documents, your paperwork, your contracts, your resumes, your CVs, and everything else that may resemble your finances, because we are going to be asking God to bless you.
You are now watching Strong Nation.
The great cry out for those who have debts and are unemployed. And every man who was in trouble was joined, and every man in debt, and every man of disgusted spirits. And he became their captain, and there were about 400 men with him. Join us in this great cry out on Monday the 27th at 5 p.m., also at 6 a.m., 10 a.m., 12 o'clock noon, at 3 p.m., and 6:30 p.m. at number 40 South Quay, Port of Spain, and all Universal Churches countrywide.
When no one else gives you the light of day, or even to hear your voice becomes a burden, prayer is the way to get the hope and strength you need to overcome your troubles. Please close your eyes. It's time for prayer.
My God and Father, in the name of Jesus, right now praying with me are people who I need of financial answers. People who I need, oh God, of a breakthrough. People who no longer agree to live the life they have lived. People, my Father, who want to see progress. People, my God, who want to achieve great results. But so far, the results they have seen are but negative, because nothing is working out for them. Their business is not working, is not progressing, is not developing, is not profitable. Their working place, their career is not moving forward. Everything they do seems, my Father, to be in vain. So, my God, I ask of you right now that you may interfere in their finances, that you may intervene, my God, in their business, that you may move your hands, your mighty hands, and remove all obstacles, remove all barriers, and enable this person to be successful with a blessing. I bless all those who now pray with me. I bless Trinidad and Tobago, our leaders. I bless, oh Father, your people who are in need of answers. And I determine that what they desire is now theirs. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Believe, God has answered you. Everything that you have presented to God this day, God has touched it and He has blessed it. And speaking about God's blessings, we are in the fasting of Daniel. These 21 days which we have begun yesterday, and we are going to go until the 23rd. We are going to be dedicating ourselves to get closer to God, to reconnect with God, to be strengthened by Him, to be revived, to be renewed. It's a great opportunity for you who feel as if you are cold in your faith, for you who need a revival, for you who need a restoration, for you who need to reconcile with God, for you who want to be filled with the Holy Spirit, for you who desire to have an experience with God, you who are hungry, you who are thirsty for the presence of God. I would like to invite you to join us. Yes, you can get to any Universal Church nationwide, and you are going to be guided how to join, how to make the Daniel's fast. these 21 days of consecration, of sanctification, when we are going to focus only, exclusively, in being filled with the presence of God. For the Word of God says that we shall receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon us. And that is what's going to happen. As it happened in the life of this lady, Kaylin, as you are going to watch her experience with the Holy Spirit. Because the experience she had, you can also have. When the Spirit of God comes upon you, you are going to become a complete new person. And this is what's going to take place in this Daniel's fast. Until the 23rd of August, we are going to be in this focus, in this spirit, to be filled with the presence of God. Please watch the testimony of Miss Kaylin, her experience with the Holy Spirit. May God bless you all, in Jesus' name.
My name is Kaylin, and before I received the Holy Spirit, I was depressed, tormented. Every night when I used to sleep, I used to feel like demons was attacking me. I used to sleep with my mom at the time, and when I slept with her, it's like when I wake up throughout the night from a bad dream, I wouldn't see her there physically, but I'll see her bones. I used to be terrified. I'll close my eyes and go back to sleep. I always used to feel like something was following me. I always used to feel like if I'm in a car, I would think that I'm going to get in a car accident. I used to wake up with scratches all over my body. It was really bad. My life was a complete mess. I used to think about ways of killing my family and either running away or killing my family and then killing myself. I was totally depressed. I had a lot of suicidal thoughts. I even reached the point where I decided to end my life because I couldn't go through the situation anymore. I thought the best way would be just to kill myself, and probably my family would have been happy without me. So one day I wrote my suicide notes and I left it on the bed. I got the rope because my granny had a lot of supplies. I got the rope and I was about to kill myself, and one question popped up in my mind. When you kill yourself, where are you going? And it got me thinking. And then I remembered my mom was constantly inviting me to the church, and I said, I'll give it 2 weeks. And if my life doesn't change in these 2 weeks, then I'll just kill myself, get over with it. Upon attending the church, the first Sunday that I went, I received miracles. I had a bleeding problem for months. I was bleeding constantly for months. And the pastor called those who had a health issue, problems in their lives, and I went in front. And I received the blessed water, and when I drank of it that entire week, I stopped bleeding immediately. I didn't have the bleeding problem after everything regularized. And I was like, okay, this is the first change that I saw. So I'll continue coming. And then the other Sunday, I saw the youths and they had this joy, this happiness about them, this togetherness. And I said, I wanted to be just like them. I wanted to have this peace that they had, this love that they had for one another. No longer I wanted my life to be the same. I decided to get baptized, and from there I started working on my communion with God. I started evangelizing, I started seeking more, I made purposes, waking up midnight to seek more, to have more of God, because I wanted to have the Holy Spirit. I was there, it was one Wednesday, and I was seeking. I poured everything that I had inside of me on the altar, every hurt that I felt, every problem, every thought, everything that was keeping me back from any past. I forgave those who needed to be forgiven, and I just poured everything out on the altar. And I seek. And that's when I received the Holy Spirit. When I received the Holy Spirit, something different inside changed in me. I no longer viewed things the same way that I used to view the things. I no longer had the hurt inside of me. I no longer felt depressed. I no longer felt the need of killing my family. I didn't have any suicidal thoughts. All of those just vanished. And now that I have the Holy Spirit, I feel the need to go out to save others. My advice to those who are watching my testimony right now, I'd like to invite all of you to come to the nearest Universal Church that's near you, because we are going to help you to overcome that situation that you are feeling, that burden that you have on your shoulders, that suicidal thought, that depression, those problems that you're going through. We are going to help you. We are going to teach you. We are going to give you one word that will help you to change your life.